So after this, you know, she is really very much unhappy, sad to know that main critics, main poets criticize her only because she is a lady writer. So what she says further, this is again a further justification. She gives this justification to women, ladies. Ladies, for its further justification to you, you mean she is not talking to the women of her period. Be pleased to know that the first copy of this play was read by several ladies of very great quality and unquestioned faith and received their most favorable opinion, not one charging it with the crime. So this play, the first copy before the play was performed on the stage. Okay, the first copy of this play was read by several women, several ladies belonging to great position, of great quality, and they are very famous people, not ordinary people, unquestioned fame, and they did not have any problem, any fault. They did not find any fault in the main variety. Rather, they have got very favorable opinion about my place, the women. Okay, and even some have been pleased to find in the acting. Means they even like the performance of the play, the staging of the play. Other ladies who saw it more than once, means some ladies read it and some went to watch this play. No, during that, before that, women were not allowed to watch, to witness the play. But during restoration period, women were allowed to go to theater. Okay. During Shakespearean period, women were not allowed. But during the restoration period, many reformations took place in British society because of the French influence. Charles II was in France for a long period of time. So that made a difference. So French society was a very liberal society, and he brought all such kind of liberal thing thoughts to Britain when he came back from the exile. Okay, so many ladies went to theater, and they went twice, thrice to see the play. They liked it a lot. And these ladies were not ordinary, you know, the common people, common women were not able to go to theater, whose quality and venture can, virtue can sufficiently justify anything they designed to favor. And they were not ordinary women, they belonged to high class society. And even they were virtuous, virtuousness having good qualities in them. They were pleased to say, they were happy to say, they found an entertainment in it. They found the play, The Lucky Chance, very entertaining. And it is far from scandalous. There is nothing objectionable. No indecency, no immorality. And for the generality of the town, I found, and apart from these great people belonging to, or women belonging to high class society, general audience of the town, I found by my receipts, it was not thought so criminal. Even general people did not find any objection in my play, as the critics find it. However, that shall not be an encouragement to me, to trouble the critics with new occasions of affronting me. Rather, she thinks that critics get an opportunity to criticize me after seeing the success of my plays. They can't, you know, tolerate my success for endeavoring at least to divert, and at this rate, both the few poets that are left and the players who toil in vain will weary of their trade. Now she thinks that if she gives them an opportunity to remain in the business, because they earn their livelihood by criticizing me. Okay, so this is how she, you know, satirizes she makes fun of these critics who do not have known that particular broad-mindedness to accept her success. She thinks that they criticize me because they cannot digest my success. And I don't take it negatively. Rather, I think that they get an opportunity to get name and fame because they do not have any other job to do, any other business to do. And finally, she says, I cannot omit to tell you. Now, she gives one example. I cannot omit to tell you. I want to tell you something more. Yes, I cannot help but to tell you that a wit of the town, she does not take a name, a friend of mine, means a very intelligent person from the town, Miss London, who is a friend of mine at Wheels Coffee House. Now, this Wheels Coffee House was a famous place, no? A famous London coffee house in Covent Garden, which was run by Willie Unwin. She refers to that. These great people would come there. Okay, they would gather together, and one of our very famous friend told her that the first night of the play cried it down as much as in Emily, who before had read it and assured me he never saw a pettier comedy. That friend told her that it is a great play and he has never seen such a wonderful comedy. So complacent one pestilent wit will be to another, and in the full cry make his noise too. But since it is to the witty few I speak, I hope the better judges will take no offense. So she calls her critics as witty few, and they don't know how to come up with the criticism. Better judges, good judges never take offense. Okay, we'll take no offense to whom I am obliged for better judgments. Those who have better judgment, better abilities, they will never find any kind of problem in my place. And those I hope will be so kind to me, knowing my conversation, not at all addicted to the indecencies alleged, that I would much less practice in it in a play that must stand the taste of the censoring world. So what she says, these good critics do not find any problem in my play. And even censor has no problem. If my plays undergo censoring correctly, they do not find any problem. But these few critics have a problem and I don't care for it, because rather it is their business, she thinks. And I must want common sense and all the degrees of good manners, renouncing my fame, all modesty and interest for silly, saucy, bootless jest, to make fools laugh and women bless and wise men assent. Okay, what she says? I must want common sense. I have a common sense. I want the critics to have this common sense and good manners. Who these people do not have common sense and good manners because they do not accept my fame. They do not have modesty. They have got all kinds of silliness. Okay? So to make fools laugh and women blush. Myself, all the while, if I had been guilty of this crime charged to me, remaining the only stupid insensible. Okay? Myself, all the while, I've been undergoing this kind of criticism for a long period of time. Is this reasonable to be believed by anybody but the willfully blind? Only blind people will believe such kind of criticism. Then all I ask is the privilege for my masculine part, the poet in me. Had I been a man, okay, they wouldn't have any problem. If any such you will allow me to trade in those successful paths my predecessors have so long thrived in, to take those measures that both the ancient and modern writers have set me, and by which they have pleased the world so well. What is wrong if I walk on the path of writing? And one thing here is problematic with Prabhan. She thinks that she is trying to follow the main itself. There should not be any problem. And I want to be the part of this particular tradition. If I must not, because of my sex, have this freedom, but that you will serve all to yourselves. I lay down my quill and you shall hear no more of me. If you can't tolerate this, then I shall stop writing. Quill is a kind of pen used in the feather pen, you might knowing that would be dipped into the ink and used for writing. So I shall stop writing if you don't accept me. Okay. So no, not so much to take make comparison, because I will be kinder to my brothers of the pain, all the poets, than they have been to a defenseless woman. Now she thinks that she is facing problem because she is a defenseless woman. This is a bit objectionable, but I am not content to write for a third day only. I am not there only for the sake of money. I do not write. I value fame as much as if I had been born a hero. And if you rob me of that, I can retire from the ungrateful world and scorn its fickle papers. So she has become a very negative in this way. And she thinks that if this continues, then I should stop writing itself. I won't write anymore. We shall talk about this last part in the next part of my discussion, because it is something objectionable. Okay, fine.